Hey guys, today I want to show you how to use a QTabWidget and how to dynamically load new tabs and work with them properly. Okay, once you have your application created, you need to obviously add a TabWidget, so just search for it. And you also need a button of some kind to actually add a new tab. So I'm just gonna use a push button and we call it new tab. And we want the slot clicked. So whenever we click the button, we add a new tab, and that's actually quite simple. We just type UI.TabWidget insert tab. You could also use add tab. So we give it the index at which we want to insert the tab. In my case, I want to insert it at the last possible, so UI.TabWidget.count. Then we give it a widget we want to add, so new Q widget. Then the icon is a Q icon. So just the location of your icon. In my case, I don't want one. So I just leave it blank. And then actually the title of the tab. So new tab in my case. And in my case, I also want to select the newly created tab. So just UI tab widget set current index. And then wherever you created a new tab, if you use the count function, make sure to add a -1, since count starts with 1 and the index obviously with 0. And if we run it, you can see whenever I hit the new tab button, I get a new tab, but it has no widgets in it. So let's create them. So in order to use the tab properly, we need to add a new QDesignerForm class. Choose widget and give it some name. So in my case, chat tab. And then you should get a header file, a CPP file, and a UI file. So I'm gonna start with the UI file. I'm just gonna add a text edit, a line edit, and a label. And whenever I press enter in the line view, I want to add whatever text in the line view to the text edit. So I go to slot, return pressed, and then UI text edit, append, UI line edit text. And I also want to clear the line edit afterwards, so UI line edit clear. And as you can see, we can pretty much work with the new tab like we would with a normal Qt project. So if, for instance, we want to use a TCP server, we could just add the TCP commands in here and then send whatever we want. And it's pretty straightforward, so we don't have to worry about which tab is open. But you're gonna see that in a moment. But first we have to change this right here, where it says Q widget, to our newly created widget, so in my case chat tab. But since we are still in C++, we also have to include the new header file, so in my case chattab.h. And if we now run the program, we should be able to create new chat tabs. And yes. And as you can see, if I add another tab, it works for only the tab that's open. So that's how you create new tabs dynamically, and I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching.